Hello everyone! Today, we're bringing you a hidden skill of wan2.2, which is first-last frame interpolation. This feature is incredibly powerful. As you can see, it can not only perform very simple first-last frame interpolation operations, but also handle very complex scenarios. For example, look at this. It involves quite a few scene and action changes. The character first lies on the ground, then stands up, walks to the table, and then sits down. As you can see, there are many actions, but you'll find that wan2.2 can excellent display all of them. Next, I will reveal how this workflow is implemented. Now, let's first look at how I discovered this feature. I initially found a post on Twitter published by ComfyUI Wiki. It mentioned that it could achieve a first, last, frame function and included a screenshot. We can click to view it. It might not be very clear, so I'll open it in a new window and zoom in, so everyone can see it clearly. As you can see, it mainly uses a node called wan1.2.2's. This node was previously used in a dedicated wan2.1 first last frame model. It has two images connected to start_image and end_image, respectively. Then, it generates new positive conditions, negative conditions, and latent, followed by wan2.2 sampling. I thought it was simple, so I tried it. First, let's look at my first workflow, built exactly as described in the post. Let's see the generated effect. This did not produce a very good first-last frame effect. It performed a scene switch, right? So, it was very disappointing. However, I felt that it should be possible. So, I made some improvements. What was the problem? It was mainly that clip vision start image and clip vision end image might not have been connected. Because we also mentioned when discussing first-last frame models before that these two are quite important. So, I improved it. Alright, let's look at my improved version. This is the first-last frame, and it can generate effects like this. And I found through testing that it is very stable in this situation. That is, it's very easy to achieve this effect. Additionally, everyone should pay attention to the frame count. My current setting is 81 frames. You should preferably change it to 121 frames. This will make it more stable. Good. This is our first usable workflow. Let's briefly summarize. We loaded the wan2.2 original high noise model and low noise model. For the weight type, I chose the FP8 UMT5 encoder and the wan2.1V encoder. Decoder, which is compatible with wan2.1. Additionally, I loaded a clip H, which we previously mentioned is a visual encoder officially released by ComfyUI. First last, frame images. Two images, mainly for two inputs. As the first and last frames of the very crucial node, wan1.2.2's. After being encoded by the encoder we just mentioned, it can generate clip vision output, which is then connected to our clip vision start image and end image. Prompt part. I kept it simple. A girl sitting on a bench, playing with her phone. There's nothing much to say. Sampling part. Before sampling, I performed acceleration. I used the Litex 2V model, which we have used multiple times. I used rank 128 LoRAs, which were added to both the high noise and low noise models. The subsequent steps are basically consistent with the official workflow. However, my sampler uses LCM, CFG uses 1.0, with 8 steps of sampling. The first 4 steps perform high noise model denoising, and the latter 4 steps perform low noise model denoising. Note the difference here. The high noise model needs to add noise. Also, return with leftover noise is set to enable, whereas it's set to disable in the official workflow. Other settings are the same. After decoding, this is the effect. It's quite good, isn't it? After this test, I wondered if it could perform interpolation for more complex actions. So, I conducted a second test. For this second test, the first and last frames became more complex. The first image shows the same character, with a similar scene, lying on the ground, picking up a phone. The second scene shows her sitting in front of a computer, working diligently. I also made corresponding changes to the prompt. I wrote, "A girl stands up, walks to the computer, sits down, and works hard." Other settings were basically the same. Looking at the final generated result, the first scene and the second scene switched directly. I felt this wasn't what I wanted. It's possible it couldn't handle complex action interpolation. But I didn't give up, so I tried another method. Then we got the third video. Take a look. In the third video, we achieved a very good effect. What improvements were made here? mainly based on these aspects. First, I made the prompt more precise. It now states, a girl stands up, walks to the computer, sits down, and works hard. All three key actions are included. I hoped the prompt could better guide the video. This is the first improvement. Second, I changed the frame length to 121 frames. This is because I believe we need to match the main model for the best effect. For wan2.2, the ideal frame count should be 121 frames. So, I changed it from 81 frames to 121 frames. Also, I previously found that if it's 81 frames, the first and last frames are actually not complete. So, based on these two considerations, I changed it. However, the resolution was not changed. It's a vertical resolution of 480 by 832. The third improvement is that I added this, a wan video nag node. This is a negative prompt node. This node was developed by Kijai and is included in the KJNODE extension package. How do you use it? I mainly use this when denoising the high noise model. We connect this negative prompt to the conditioning, then connect the model. The connected model is then sent to our save value. This way, the negative prompt becomes quite effective. In the negative prompt, I added an element called scene transition. This means I don't want a scene transition effect to appear. This can effectively ensure that we achieve the desired function within the same scene. So, we achieved a fantastic effect, didn't we? Therefore, the final workflow state should look like this. Some might ask if this workflow is generalizable. Let's test a more complex example. Take a look. Here are two images. The characters in these two images are related but don't look exactly the same. The basic composition is similar, but the backgrounds are different, and the clothes are also different. However, we wanted to have a costume change effect. So, as you can see, I still used this workflow. I changed the prompt to a girl walking, a golden light flashes, and the girl changes her costume. Let's look at the effect. The girl has a walking motion, but she didn't actually move. Her body twisted. That's fine. Then, we see a golden light flash, and the girl changes her costume. This is a very impressive effect. So, you'll find that the interpolation capability is very strong. Even if the first and last frames have significant scene changes, we can still complete this task very well. So, this is the workflow we discussed today. Let's briefly summarize some key points. The main model must be I to V, not T to V. I did not use VACE. If you use VACE, it might be a different scenario. Always remember to connect the clip vision, start image, clip vision, end image, start image, and end image. The frame count must be 121 frames. The prompt must be detailed, making it easier for the model to achieve a smooth transition. This is very crucial. Remember to add the nag node. Before adding it, we need to write scene transition in the negative prompt. Additionally, many people might have this question. Why is nag only added to the high noise model and not the low noise model? This is actually fundamentally related to the principle of wan2.2. We all know that wan2.2 is a multimodal expert MO model. It switches between the high noise model and the low noise model. The switching criterion refers to the signal-to-noise ratio, SNR. If it reaches 1:1, meaning the ratio of signal-to-noise is 1:1, then it switches. This can be seen in the original paper. However, you should note that in ComfUI, it cannot achieve automatic switching. Therefore, ComfUI uses a crude method, which is first four steps, then last four steps. If it's the first four steps and the last four steps, we cannot guarantee that the SNR at this time is exactly 1:1. This can only be described as a crude substitute method. As we've mentioned when discussing many models before, implementing MO models in ComfUI is quite difficult. But you must understand that, based on fundamental principles, the high noise model is used to construct the outline. The low noise model is used for optimization, refinement. Once the basic outline is constructed, the general actions and basic animation are already generated. Therefore, I only need to ensure that the high noise model can construct the desired scene during composition. Then, during refinement, because it's limited by the high noise model, meaning my composition is already set, you can only refine within this framework. You cannot deviate from this framework, right? So, it's not needed here. I want to remind everyone not to overlook the technology itself and treat it merely as a tool. This will limit your development. Alright, that's all for today. I hope this way of thinking provides some basic inspiration for everyone. What are you waiting for? Go and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.